Hi, my name is Vineet Vaibhav and I'm the Chief Development Officer for Wellspun One. I welcome all of you to the knowledge session on warehousing, and today we are going to talk about Grade A warehouses. I have segregated the entire discussion into three parts. The first part will talk about the evolution of the warehouse and what are the critical elements of a Grade A warehouse. We'll then move into the design elements of the Grade A warehouses, and third and the final is we'll talk about the delivery, the operations, and I'll summarize the entire discussion. I'm sure all of you are aware that warehouses are no longer just godowns. These have today transformed into sophisticated, state-of-the-art, and strategically located facilities. What we need to understand of a Grade A warehouse is there are two critical aspects. One is the scale and the complexity. When I talk about scale of the warehouse, I talk about the size of the warehouse. So in our experience, what we have seen is, if you do not have the right scale of a warehouse, if you do not have the right size requirement of a warehouse, then you do not need a Grade A warehouse. When we talk about the size, you minimum need to have a requirement of 100,000 square feet of a warehouse. That is on the size. When we talk about the complexity, we talk about the complexity of the operation that will go into the inside the warehouse. If you do not have very complicated warehouse operations, then you again do not need a Grade A warehouse. So again, the Grade A warehouse requirement is based on scale and the complexity of the operations. Now that we have touched upon the scale and the complexity, we will be able to figure out who the right tenants for a Grade A warehouse would be, who needs a Grade A warehouse. So when we talk about who needs the Grade A warehouse, we can obviously talk about third-party logistic companies, the e-commerce companies, the pharma companies, the FMCG and the retail companies. These are the set of the clients that we should be targeting. Again, it's very important to understand their operations, to understand if they really need a Grade A warehouse or not. Now that we have understood the evolution of the warehouse, we need to now know the design elements of a warehouse. When we talk about a design of a Grade A warehouse, the first thing which comes to the mind is the height of the building. The height of the building should be 11 meters at eve minimum for a Grade A design. The second important element of a Grade A design is the flooring of the warehouse. The flooring should be designed for 5 tons per square meters and it should be FM2 floors. The third important aspect is the docking, number of docks available in a warehouse. We all know that there are so many trucks coming in and going out on a daily basis. Now, the dock should be sufficient to ensure that the turnaround times for the docking and undocking of our trucks is kept to a minimum. To cater to those kind of demand, we need to have minimum one dock every 10,000 square feet of plinth area. It can be less, but it cannot be more. The fourth important aspect of the whole warehouse design is the apron length. We all need to design the entire park, including the aprons for a 40 feet trailers and the supporting infra, which is the road infra, to be supporting the movement of 40 feet trailers unhindered. When we talk about the overall Grade A design, we also need to talk about the entire park infra design. Just the building Grade A design does not matter, because entire park should cater to Grade A requirements. When we talk about the Grade A requirements of a park, we talk about CCTVs, we talk about full-time security, talk about good landscape, we talk about all the roads available inside a park to be catering to a 40 feet trailer. It can be 2-lane, it can be 4-lane, depending on the size of the park, but it has to cater to a 40 feet trailer. Other things which are important is the design of the gate. The gate should be sufficiently designed and there should be sufficient lane for all the trucks to come in and move out at the minimum turnaround time levels. Now, this is important to understand that there are, at peak level for the large park, the trucks can be thousands. So it is important to have sufficient number of entry gates, sufficient number of exit gates on the project. Now that we have discussed the operations and the design of the warehouse, we need to understand the delivery and the post-delivery operations of the warehouse. We need to take care that we have the right project management team and the right site team who understands the design which you have designed and helps you deliver those park in reality on ground. If you do not have the right project management, the site team, in true sense, you will not be able to achieve a Grade A park. Once your park is delivered, you also need to have the right operations team for the post-delivery phase of the project, because it is equally important to have the best property management and the best asset management team for you to maintain your park as a Grade A park throughout the life cycle of the project. All in all, if I have to sum up the entire discussion, you first need to summarize and know who is your client. Then you need to know what is their operation. You need to design your park as per their operation. You need to then have the right delivery team who can help you realize the potential of the design and helps you deliver the project to truly grade A standard. And finally, you need to have the best operations team who can manage the park in true sense to be a grade A park. I hope this helps you in conceptualizing your grade A park, which you are coming up in future. Thank you.